Faculty IIBF. So in today's session, what we will be seeing, the learning objectives would be to know different types of securities, what are the various types of securities, what are different modes of creating charge, how we will create charge on these securities, what are the various modes. Then we will look at some of the advances which are popularly used, that is advance against standing crops or other agriculture produce, loan against life insurance policies, loan against deposits, and loan against gold ornaments. So in today's session, we will be seeing all these things. Okay. First of all, let us go into what are the various types of securities. In an earlier unit, we have discussed about principles of lending, where we have talked about securities. Why the bank take a security? It is mainly to fall back upon as a cushion whenever the borrower does not repay the loan as per the schedule. So it is only a cushion. Let us see what are the different types of securities. You all know types of securities will have agricultural land, land and building, plant and machinery, embedded to earth, farm machinery like tractors, power tillers, vehicles, agricultural implements. It could be gold ornaments also. Type of security will also include life insurance policies. It could be even our own deposit. That is also security, isn't it? Then you will have, if it is against agriculture produce, what you will take? Raw material, finished goods, and agriculture producers. These are all will be the securities. If you take raw material, finished goods, then what next will come? Book debts and other trade receivables. So these are all the various types of securities. What are the various modes of creating charge? Each one will differ. If it is a land and building, it will be mortgage. Everybody knows about it. If it is a raw material, it has to be an hypothecation, or it can be even a pledge. Pledge is a very popular form of doing it in agriculture in villages. Then it could be even book debts also, hypothecation of book debts. Then you have the assignment part of it, how the life insurance policies can be assigned. Then you have type of mode of creating charges, one another charge is lien. You mark a lien and then you set it off. You get a deposit as a lien for the loan and you will set it off when the borrower does not pay it. So what are the various types of creating charge? So it could be mortgage, it could be assignment, hypothecation, pledge, or lien. See, type of securities could be either personal or it could be tangible. What is personal security? If a personal security means a personal liability of the borrower or the guarantor. If they give their own security, if they give a guarantee, or the borrower is personally liable, then we call it as a personal liability. What is tangible security? Tangible security is something which he offers you, say land and building, or even it could be raw material also, whatever it is. Then what are the other types of securities? It can be classified as either primary or a collateral security. What do we mean by a primary security? Primary is the main security for an advance created out of the advance given. Primary is basically the security which is created out of the advance we have given to a borrower. That is what is called as primary. Collateral is something given by the borrower which has not been created out of the advance. So it is a security which is other than the primary security given to the bank by a borrower or by a third party. It's not necessary that only the borrower has to give the collateral security. It could be a guarantor who is a third party. He is not a party to the advance, but he is standing as a guarantor. He is standing as a guarantor and he is offering his property as security. Then it is called as collateral security. If some primary, if standing crops, stocks or machinery which are created out of the advance given to a borrower, then that is called as primary security. So the difference between primary and collateral security, you all should know. Types of charges, as I already said, it is mortgage, hypothecation, pledge, assignment and lien. So we will look into each one of it, what do they stand for and how we can create this charge. First, we'll go to mortgage. Okay. Mortgage is the charge created on immovable properties like land and building. It is generally created for immovable properties, not for movable. Movable is generally hypothecation or pledge. Mortgage is the charge created on immovable properties like land and building. It can be a simple mortgage or a mortgage by deposit of title deeds. You all must have heard about a thing called equitable mortgage. Equitable mortgage is nothing but mortgage created by deposit of title deeds with the banker. So mortgage can be either a simple mortgage or a mortgage by deposit of title deeds. Simple mortgage is created by a deed which is registered with registrar of assurances. It is a mortgage is created by a deed which is to be registered with the registrar of assurances. Equitable mortgage is done by deposit of title deeds by mortgagor with the mortgagee. Here, who is the mortgagor? Generally, the borrower. The mortgagee is the banker. In the event of default, lending bank may bring the property for sale. What the lending bank will do? If the borrower does not pay, what they will do is they will sell the property and take back their money. That is what the purpose for which the mortgage is taken is to fall back upon when the borrower does not pay his money as per the scheduled terms. Okay. Before accepting property, as we have already discussed about the basic principles of lending, the security which we take should be marketable. It should be free from encumbrances and it should be realizable, easy to handle also. We cannot just take anything as security. So before accepting property as security, you all must be knowing there will be title verification to be done by the bank's lawyer. You will always do that. One is by lawyer and the valuation is to be done by the approved valuer. The person in whose name the property stands must have, the person who is giving the property, he should have a good, valid and marketable title over the property. Tomorrow, somebody else should not come and tell the banker that the property belongs to some other person and not to the borrower. So such a thing should not happen. So we have to do the title search properly. For that, we take the help of an advocate. You should have the person, that is the borrower to whom we are giving the money, you should have a good, valid and marketable title over the property. Then valuation of the property to be done by approved valuer. So we should know what is the value of the property. We may be giving an advance of say 1 lakh and we are going to take a property of say 20,000. Then if there is no other security, then we may get only 20,000 at the time of if the borrower does not pay. So we need to know, it's not necessary that we have to take 100% as security, but we need to know upfront, in case the borrower does not pay, how much you will get by realizing the security. Bank should also inspect the property offered as security to ensure correctness of the particulars given by the proponent. So inspection is a very important thing before we take any property as security. We should know whether the property, such a property exists. It does. It's not only paper security. It should. It exists. If the land is leasehold, if the borrower is not the owner of the land, freehold property is a leasehold property. Leasehold means it is given to him for a particular period. He can enjoy the rights over the land, say for 10 years, 25 years, or it could be even 100 years. If the land is leasehold, it should be ascertained whether the terms of the lease permit the borrower to assign or transfer by way of mortgage the leasehold rights to the land. See, if he doesn't have the right to assign it or transfer it to the bank, we cannot take it as a security. So we should examine and see whether he has got the right to assign or transfer by way of mortgage the leasehold rights in the land. Repayment of loan by the borrower not to exceed the period of lease. In such a case, when we take a leasehold land, we should ensure the period of lease is something more than the period for which the loan is advanced. Okay. Now, we will see what are the documents we normally take from the mortgagor, because mortgage is the most popular way of giving loan. So we are looking in detail about the documents to be taken from the mortgagor. All the material documents of title, like it could be a sale deed, it could be a gift deed, it could be a will, or it could be a partition deed. Whatever the deed which convey the title in the favor of the borrower has to be taken. Then you have to take the parent documents for the prescribed period. Normally, generally the banks take for 30 years to ascertain the flow of title. How the title has been transferred from one person to another over a period of last 30 years. Okay. Then the encumbrance certificate. You all must be knowing what it is, an encumbrance certificate. Normally for 13 years to see if any encumbrance subsists on the property, whether the borrower has already mortgaged it to somebody else or not. That has to be ensured. It should be free from encumbrance. Then the tax receipt for the property to evidence the possession of the property by the proposed mortgagor. This is also one way of verifying whether the mortgagor is the real owner of the property. If he is not the real owner, why he will be paying the tax receipt? If he has got the tax receipt, it is also, it's a comfort to the banker that he is the real owner of the property. If the property offered is standing in the name of a minor, permission of the competent court to encumber the property. If it stands in the name of the minor, we have to be a bit careful and we should take the permission of the competent court. Search report. If the mortgage whole property belongs to a company, if it belongs to a company, we need to have a search report in order to ascertain any charge is subsisting on the property. It should be done with registrar of companies. It should be done. ROC search has to be done. And now we have this CERSAI also. We will move on to some of the most popular or generally used loans and advances. The first and the foremost in a village would be advance against standing crops and other agricultural produce. So how we give this loan? This is the most popular one for a farmer, isn't it? A farmer will be taking an advance against standing crops and other agricultural produce. So the banks advance loans against the security of standing crops and agricultural produce. The banks generally give loan against the security of either it's a standing crop and agricultural produce. It could be by way of loan, key cash credit, or open cash credit. What is key cash credit? It's nothing but pledge. Who will have the key? Who will have the key here? The banker will have the key here. So it is called the key cash credit. It's a pledge. It is kept in a godown. So as and when the lodgement is done, the banker will be advancing to the borrower. As and when he takes back the money, he has to repay the loan. Then only he will release the produce. Okay, that is how the system of pledge works. If it is an open cash credit, then a hypothecation will be done. So he will be enjoying the credit, but he will be declaring every month he is holding it on behalf of the bank. So when possession of goods is transferred to the bank, charge created is called as pledge. In the case of pledge, the possession is with the banker. He has got the key to the godown. So basically, he is holding the possession of the goods. When possession is not transferred, nature of charge created is called hypothecation. The produce, the raw material, the finished goods will be lying with the borrower who will be doing, go on doing it. But he, against that goods, raw material, he will get a drawing power. He will give a statement of stocks and book debts against which the banker will allow drawings, which is called hypothecation of cash credit hypothecation. Hypothecation charge is created. Okay. No advance should be made for speculation or hoarding purposes. As we have already seen under the basic principles of lending, no advance should be given for any speculative purposes. Goods should have been fully paid. Then only they can be hypothecated to the, now we can permit drawings against the goods. It should have been fully paid. So age of the shop should be reasonable. It should not be very old stock. If it is, say, more than a year old, if it is a agriculture produce, then we cannot realize it. No, how can we sell it and the banker cannot? So the age of the stock should be reasonable. It should be, say, up to 3 months. And if it's not perishable, it could be even 6 months. Okay, not more than that. Ownership to be ensured by verifying the original paid invoice. We have to ensure the ownership of the goods while going for inspection. We have to see original paid invoices. Appropriate margin to be maintained. We cannot give, supposing if he is showing a stock of, say, 1 lakh, we cannot give the entire 1 lakh to him. We take some margin, isn't it? Margin is what is money. He has to put some of his money into the business. So that we have to ensure. So normally 10 to 25% of margin is deducted and the balance only is given to him by way of cash credit. Goods to be stored separately in a godown in case of pledge. In the case of pledge, it has to be securely and it should be stored separately. If he has got in the godown, different, it should be segregated. It should be known clearly that the goods belong to the banker because it has been given as pledge to the bank. And foremost important one is goods should be adequately insured. Either it is an hypothecation of goods or a pledge of goods, both should be adequately insured. Insurance means in case of fire, theft or any flood or anything, the insurance company will make good the amount to the insurer, whoever has insured it. Generally, we will ask the borrower to assign the insurance policy. The bank's interest has to be noted in the policy. It's not assignment. It should be noted. The interest of the bank, hypothecation clause has to be incorporated in the insurance policy. So that as and when fire happens, the insurance company will pay the money directly to the bank. That is what the intention. Now, we'll go look into the loan against life insurance policies. Sometimes the borrower will not be having any security, or he may be having some life insurance policies. He will come to you, the bank has, please give me some amount against this life. You keep this life insurance policy with you and give me some money. I need it for many purposes for his business purposes, for his personal needs, whatever could be the reason. So what we have to look into when they ask for loan against life insurance policies, the first thing we should say the whether the policy is in force and whether they have paid the premium up to date every year, or every year they need to pay the premium, whether they have paid the premium up to date. The latest premium receipt should be kept on record by the bank. The policy should be original, duly stamped and signed by the issuing authority. Whichever insurance company is issuing the policy, it should be the original policy. The insurance company should have admitted the age of the assured. That is, whoever's life is being assured by the insurance company, his age should have been admitted, acknowledged. Bank lent against the life policies based on surrender value. What is surrender value? You take the policy to the insurance company. You say, I am not going to renew the policy. You please give me whatever premium I have paid so far, that you give me back. So the insurance company will work out. If they surrender the policy, they will work out what money they can give back. So generally, the bank also will go up to the surrender value of the policy. This is what is called a surrender value. Policy need to be assigned to the lender. Here, the mode of charge is assignment. Not only it should be assigned, the assignment notice to be given to the insurance company. You have to give the assignment notice to the insurance company. Then only in the case of death of life assured, assignee is entitled to receive the policy amount. In this case, the assignee is the banker, because we have given money against the life insurance policies. Okay, we'll move on to loan against term deposit. It's a very, very popular way of giving advance. You know, most of the banks, because the depositor will need the money, so he will take the loan. It is against his own money. So banks lend against the term deposit, such as fixed deposit, cumulative deposit or recurring deposit. The nature of facility granted against a security of term deposit may either be a loan or an overdraft. It could be a loan for a certain period, or it should be paid over a period of time, or it could be an overdraft. Overdraft means they can deposit as and when they have money and again withdraw it up to a limit. That is what is called as overdraft. The nature of charge created in this case is pledge. So they are pledging the term deposit and taking a loan from the bank. Normally, banks will lend only up to 90% of the deposit amount, accrued value of the deposit. What do you mean by accrued value of the deposit? That means the interest which has accrued on the deposit up till that point. So we always keep a margin of some 10%. In some cases, it could be even 15%, or it can be even 5%, that depending upon the bank's policies and all. Then you have the rate of interest charge on the loan would be, generally it will be 1 or 2% above the interest rate offered on the deposit. So loan against deposit may, it could be either 1 or 2% more than the interest rate offered on the deposit. The borrower can repay the loan out of his or her sources on any day before the maturity. Before the maturity of the deposit, he can close the loan. If not paid in full before the maturity of the deposit, the amount of deposit will be adjusted towards the loan also. Supposing if the borrower fails to pay the loan against the deposit on the date of the maturity of the deposit, what the bank will do? They will adjust the amount of deposit towards the loan and give the balance, if any, to the borrower. That is how it will be done. This is what is called as loan against term deposit. And normally, no loan can be granted against a security deposit receipt standing in the name of a minor. You cannot normally lend against a security deposit of a minor. But sometimes, for the benefits of the minor, the guardian, which may be a father or a mother, the loan is sought by the guardian for the necessities of the minor depositor. The bank may consider it on getting from the guardian an undertaking letter to the effect. So they will get a letter from their guardian that this money is needed for the necessities of the minor. So in such a case, we can give loan against the security of deposit receipt standing in the name of a minor. Deposit receipt should be duly discharged by the depositor holder. He has to discharge it at the back of the deposit receipt. In case of more than one deposit holder, all of them should discharge the deposit receipt. They all should discharge the deposit. The depositor should also execute necessary loan documents. Loan can be granted against deposit receipt of other branches of the same bank. You can give it against. The only thing you have to mark the lien should be noted in the records of the branch from where the deposit was made. Okay. Now, we'll come to the final one, that is loan against gold ornaments. This is again one of the most popular way of taking loan in a village. Banks give loans against gold ornaments for agriculture as well as non-agriculture purpose. The purpose could be either agriculture or it could be non-agriculture, that is for the personal uses also. The nature of charge created here is pledge, because they are pledging their ornaments with the bank. They will pledge the gold ornaments to the bank and ask the bank to give the advance. The amount of loan and ornaments depends upon the market value and purity of the gold. It depends on the market value of the gold. So the bank will normally take some margin of say 30% and then give the balance amount as loan. The market value will depend upon on day-to-day basis, whatever is the market value. On that basis, banks will take some margin. Normally, banks keep a margin of around 30% on the market value of the ornaments. The rate of interest varies with the purpose of the loan. If it is an agriculture purpose, the rate of interest may be a lesser one. And if it is a non-agriculture purpose, it could be more. So the repayment period depends on the purpose of the loan. Again, the repayment you have to synchronize with the purpose of the loan. If the loan is for agriculture purpose, the repayment period should normally coincide with the harvest and marketing of the produce. If you don't coincide that, they will not be able to repay it. If they have taken it for an agriculture purpose, unless they harvest the produce and get the money, they will not be able to repay it. So we have to fix up the repayment schedule in such a way it will coincide with your harvest date and the marketing of the produce. On closure of the loan, when they close the loan, the ornament should be returned to the pledger, that is to the borrower, or to his authorized representative. In case of a default in repayment of loan, the bank as pledgee has a right to sell the ornaments pledged in an auction. They will do an auction. It could be a private sale, but they have to give a notice to the pledger, which is the borrower, of their intention to sell it. They have to give him a reasonable time. If you do not pay us before such and such date, we will be forced to sell the gold ornaments and realize our loan amount. Bank also appoints appraiser for the purpose of checking the purity of the gold ornaments. Because the bank officer may not know whether the gold is, what is the purity of the gold, they normally appoint an appraiser who will check the purity of the gold and say that it can be taken as pledge. So these are all the various modes of creating charge. So today we have discussed what are the various modes of creating charge. And we have also seen what are the precautions we have to take when we take mortgage of landed property. And we have also seen what are the popular way of getting loan, whether it's loan against deposit, loan against life insurance policies, or loan against gold ornaments, or against standing crops. These are the four normally more popular way of taking loan. And creating charge would be either it could be mortgage in case of land and building, it could be hypothecation or pledge in case of standing crops, it could be assignment in case of LIC policies, life insurance policies.